Hello and welcome to a new RPGle example video. Today I'd like to talk about RPGle templates. Let's go. As always, I'm in VS Code using code for IBMI. If you want to know how to install it and how to use it, you can watch some of my videos about it in my channel. Well, let me show you a simple program that I have made. This one. Well, as you see, this is a program that has a main procedure and one sub-procedure. It is a very simple program. The sub-procedure is returning a character value, okay? If something happens, this value will be Y. Otherwise, the sub-procedure is returning N. Well, look at the entry. Is it clear for you what's the meaning of this value? No, it is not clear. I don't know what it is about. Well, this is one of the answers about why using a template. A template is just an undefined type, or better said, it's a way for renaming a data type to make it clearer in the code. But also it can be used to create undefined data structures that can be passed as parameters or returned by a procedure. So if we use them in this program, we can change the data type of the value returned by the sub-procedure into a more clearer data type, for example, error type. Let me do it. Let's go here. I'm going to, let me do it here, declare error type. And it is going to be a character value and template. Okay, what I have to change here in the sub-procedure, well, it's going to be like error type. And here I can do it in the same way. So this way, we are helping the people that read the code to understand it better. Well, imagine that we need to return more information than a simple value from a sub-procedure. In that case, we will need to use a template to define a data structure. Let me do it. Let me create something like this. Other error type. And for example, we are going to have a code that is going to be the error code. And text that is going to be the error message. Okay. Let me create a new sub-procedure here that is going to return a value of this type. Subproc to and. Let me write the entry, like in this case, like the S, other error type. Okay. Well, as you see, now I'm returning a data structure. So let me declare a data structure, error, like the S, other error, and it is going to be initialized like the data structure definition. Okay, well, this structure will be returned by the sub procedure, and that's why I have declared it. Okay, as you see, using like the S here, I'm telling the compiler that I want this variable to be initialized as it is defined in the template. So for example, if I define that code is going to be initialized to 99 here, and put it here, then it will be initialized to 99 at the beginning of the sub-procedure, okay? Well, as in the other sub-procedure, is something wrong happens then I will change the error code to some value and the text to the error message. For example, error.code is going to be 99, error text is going to be an error has happened. For example, and return error. So this way I'm returning all this information into the same field. In the main procedure, I have to check the content of the code value to know if the execution has been wrong or not. So let me go here to the main. And in this case, I will need to declare a variable in the same way I have done into the sub procedure type. And now error is equal to sub procedure 2. And if error.code is different than 0, then I will write the error text. Else, no error detect, for example. Okay, so as you see, templates are a pretty good way for making our code clear to other programmers. Also, remember that the variable defined with the template keyword is not generated into the module. For passing structures as parameters or returning them, I will need to use templates too. I hope you liked this video. Please remember to give a like to it and to subscribe. And as always, thanks for watching.